What a trip. That was exciting. Hey, Bubba.
What's up, Dewey? How you doing?
I'm doing well, man. Doing well. Excited. Just got back from a fishing trip.
Fishing trip?
Yeah.
Why didn't I get invited?
I didn't know you liked to fish.
Well, makes sense.
Okay. All right. You want to know where I went fishing?
Where?
I was fishing on the Sea of Galilee, over there where Jesus walked.
Did you see Jesus?
No, I didn't see Jesus.
Oh, man.
Nope.
I want to see Jesus.
Didn't see him, but I was fishing on the Sea of Galilee. It was so exciting. But I'm glad to be back here at the Sovereign Historical Biblical Library Institute, also known as Shibley. It's a great place to be here reading all these books. What are you reading?
You got really good books. It's about a book about a kid and some apples. But I'm really not understanding anything it's telling me.
There's a reason for that, Bubba.
Why is that?
I've got to turn the book this way.
Oh, there. Makes sense.
Now we can read it.
Yeah.
Yep. All right. So we're just going to... Hey, look.
Oh, yeah. I've got my own personal filming crew now.
Oh, look at all those kids out there.
Yeah. You see them?
Hey, y'all. Glad to have you here at the library. This is, I think you heard me say it before, but this is the Sovereign Historical Biblical Library Institute, also known as Shibley. It is an exciting place to be. Now, this week, we're going to help introduce you to things that are happening as we go through our Vacation Bible School. You know, the first thing that's going to happen today, you know what it's going to be? We got a song coming up. That's right. We got a song coming up. And it's called Yes. Yes. Yes to, guess what?
Apples.
No. No. Yes to, what is this?
VBS.
VBS.
Yes.
Yes. Yes. No. To VBS. Enjoy the song.
Everybody say yes. Yes. To VBS.
VBS.
Hey everybody, welcome back. Wasn't that a great song? Isn't that that's a fun song to sing. I love singing yes to VBS. So does Professor Dewey here.
Yeah. What? Ow.
They're back. The song is over.
It's over?
It is over.
It's over?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
They're waiting on you to talk to them.
I'm sorry. That was a fun song, though. I really liked it. Hey, you know what we're getting ready to do now? We're getting to go to a Bible story.
Oh,
yeah, a Bible story set back in biblical times. So we're going to go to one of our tribe tents, and we're going to have one of our tribe leaders tell you a story. It's going to be lots of fun. We're going to learn about how Jesus is the Son of God and that He is our Savior. So here we go. Listen to our Bible story.
Have you ever been someplace where you were made to wear one of these? We often wear name tags on the first day of school so that our teachers and classmates will get to know our names. But knowing our names doesn't necessarily mean they know who we are. We are not just Sarah or Adam or Monica or Daniel. We are soccer players, artists, musicians, writers, basketball players, sons and daughters, and so much more. Many people know the name of Jesus, but not everyone knows who Jesus is. The Bible teaches us that Jesus is God's Son. It tells us that Jesus gave up his throne in heaven to live on earth as a man. It tells us he died for our sins so that he could give us eternal life. Jesus has changed the lives of millions of people over the centuries. Though no one living today has seen him face to face, many know him as their Savior and will tell you he has changed their life. Who is Jesus? He is the Christ. He is the Son of God. He wants to save you from your sins. We are all curious about one thing or another. If you were to look at your record of checked out his library books or your search engine on Google, I'm sure we'd find all sorts of curiosities in there. Some of you are curious to know more about history. Some are curious about sports and sports heroes. Some are curious about famous historical figures or celebrities. Some of you are probably very curious about the next Marvel or Star Wars movie. Many people, whether they are religious or not, are curious about Jesus. There is no denying that more than 2,000 years ago, a man named Jesus from the town of Nazareth walked the earth. But many people are curious to know if Jesus really is who he claims to be. Was he just a man? Was he a good teacher or a prophet? Was he a phony trying to pretend to do miracles? Or was he something more? We're going to start with the most basic question. Who is Jesus? Jesus asked that question himself to his disciples, and it was one of his most outspoken disciples who first gave us the answer. We're going to read Matthew 16, verses 13 through 23 together. When Jesus came to the region of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say the Son of Man is?" They replied, "Some say John the Baptist, others say Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." "But what about you?" he asked. "Who do you say I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Christ, the Son of the living God." Jesus replied, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah, for this was not revealed to you by man, but by my Father in heaven. And I tell you, Peter, that on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not overcome it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven. Whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." Then he warned his disciples not to tell anyone that he was the Christ. From that time on, Jesus began to explain to his disciples that he must go to Jerusalem and suffer many things at the hands of the elders, chief priests, and teachers of the law, and that he must be killed and on the third day be raised to life. Peter took him aside and began to rebuke him. "Never, Lord," he said. "This shall never happen to you." Jesus turned to Peter and said, "Get behind me, Satan. You are a stumbling block to me. You do not have in mind the things of God, but the things of men." The people who saw Jesus in person perform miracles and teach were astonished by him. Jesus was a simple carpenter by trade, not a priest or a scholar, and yet his teachings astounded them. Some people thought he might be a prophet, like the Old Testament prophet Elijah. Some thought he was simply a good man or a teacher. But the men who knew Jesus best saw the truth. Jesus was the Christ. He was God's Son in the flesh. God had long promised to send a Savior to the earth, and Jesus had come to save the whole world from sin. Jesus was the only man who never sinned, and his death on the cross paid the price for all of our sins. We believe Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, not simply because of what Peter said, but because of what Jesus did and how his life has changed so many lives, even to this day. In spite of Peter's confession and the words of the Bible, there are people today who think Jesus was just a man. They consider him a great teacher, maybe even a prophet, but not the Son of God. If it was just a lie, or if Jesus was out of his mind, someone would have figured it out. Someone would have spilled the beans. Peter was one of the disciples who would die for believing in Jesus, one of millions in the history of the church. Their courage and their faith show us they were fully convinced Jesus was the Christ, the Son of God. They died so that we might know that we can trust our lives to Jesus as well. Who is Jesus? He is God's Son. He is our Savior. He is more than a good teacher or a prophet. He is the only one who can save us from sin.
May you have power with all God's people to understand Christ's love. May you know how wide and long and high and deep it is. Ephesians 3:18.
Hey, welcome back. What are you doing?
I'm licking my fingers. I'm cleaning my hands.
Why?
You know, washing them, huh?
That's not how you wash your fingers, but why are you doing that?
Well, because I had some of those cinnamon rolls from the drive-thru. Did you get any?
Yesterday?
Yeah.
There's still cinnamon rolls on your fingers from yesterday.
Yeah, well, I didn't have time to wash yesterday, guys.
Okay.
I knew we were going to be doing this. And
you need to wash your hands, Bubba. Did you get some of those cinnamon rolls? If you didn't, I'm so sorry, but they were delicious. They were really good. I did have some, but I washed my hands since then. Well, listen, I hope you had a great time today as we sang yes to VBS and we heard our Bible story. And I just hope that you come back and join us tomorrow. It's going to be an exciting time as we continue our Vacation Bible School 2020.
See y'all on TV tomorrow. Bye.
That's enough.